In this video, I'm going to show you how to train a neural network to detect whether a video clip is in-game or not. The code we're going through was created by two friends and me and is published on GitHub. Link in the description. If you first want to learn the basics of neural networks, make sure to check out my Neural Networks Explained video before continuing. To kick things off, we have to decide which game the neural network should detect. Let's use Fortnite for this video. Note that I'll explain each step in a way that you can easily adapt it for the game of your choice, or even other image and video classification tasks. Now we need to create a dataset for the neural network. The dataset needs to consist of Fortnite in-game images and images that are not in-game. For me, images in an active round are counted as in-game, so if an image shows a lobby, item shop, or anything that is not in an active round, it's counted as not in-game. To build the dataset, we need to download a bunch of videos. Some of them should be about Fortnite, for example a Fortnite highlight compilation, and the others about other games, so that the context is the same. Having downloaded a bunch of videos, it's time to head to GitHub and download the repository. Note that you can also download a released version which already contains a trained neural network. Also make sure to check out the setup section in the README so that you can run the Python scripts. If everything is set up, we can place the videos into the assets/video folder in the repository and execute the video-to-images script. The script takes one video at a time and extracts an image from it every 300 frames. Feel free to change the number of frames between two extracted images. However, I would recommend to let a few seconds pass between two images so that there are not too many similar images in the dataset. After the script has finished, we have a new folder named Images. In there are all the images that got extracted from the videos. And now we're at the most time-consuming task, which is grouping the images into two different folders. The first one should be named like the game name, so Fortnite in our case. And the second must be named No Game. I would recommend to have the same amount of images in each folder. So if you have 100 in-game images and 200 no-game images, remove 100 of them or try to get 100 more in-game images. If you're done, congrats, you have created a dataset that we can now use to train the neural network. So let's jump into the game detection script. In here is some code to create a neural network. I'll briefly go through it after we've trained and tested our first neural network. Let's scroll down to the end, where we initialize the neural network and call its train method. There are a bunch of parameters that we can set for the initialization. The two important ones for now are game name and dataset path. The game name must be the same as the folder name containing the in-game images in our dataset, so it's Fortnite in our case. Then, the path to the dataset should be the full path to the folder containing the Fortnite and no-game subfolders. On a MacBook, you can easily get it by right-clicking the dataset folder, holding the Option key and selecting Copy dataset as path name. Now we can run the script to train the neural network. When the training has finished, we can find the neural network in form of an h5 file in the root folder. Let's rename it to fortnite.h5 and place it into our models folder. Now we should test our trained network on a few videos. So let me create a folder named Test and place two videos in there. Let's take a look at the videos. We can see that one should preferably be classified as in-game and the other as not in-game. To verify this, let's head to the predict script and adjust a few parameters. The name of the model and the path to the model should be correct. But the video name showing the in-game clip needs to be updated as well as the path to it. Now everything looks good and we can run the script. As we can see, the neural network was able to detect that the video is in-game. So let's check the other video. Great, it seems like the dataset was good enough to train the neural network. So how does it work, and why do we just need a bunch of training images for such a complex task? That's thanks to a concept called transfer learning. It works by starting off with a huge neural network that was trained on millions of images. So the network can already detect specific objects like trees or stones or specific patterns, which makes it easier to learn how a typical Fortnite in-game image looks like. That's why we only need such a small data set. If we look at the code, my friends and I decided to offer three different trained networks. They are called ResNet 50, VGG 16 and Inception V3. And after a few tests on them, we decided to use ResNet 50 as the default one. If you want to know more about one or more of those networks, check out the description where I added a few links with additional information. Now let's briefly go through the three scripts. If you just want to use and not modify or understand the scripts, you should be good to go. Enjoy using them and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks! The first script is video2images.py, and there's nothing complicated in there. We first set a bunch of variables that should be self-explanatory, then create the folder where the images are extracted to and finish off with a for loop iterating through each video in the videos folder and extracting every 300th frame. That's it. The second script is gamedetection.py, and opposed to the first one, this one is quite complex. We create a game detection object that has a few parameters. Just pause the video here if you want to read the parameter descriptions. The next interesting snippet is the creation of an image data generator. This is an object from the Keras library that can load and pre-process images in real time before passing them to the neural network for training. We pass it a self-written pre-processing function that transforms each image into grayscale. Why? Because the colors are not really important to detect a Fortnite scene, and using colors would just increase the difficulty for training. Then we call the flowFromDirectory method with a bunch of parameters to get a handle to our dataset. The method returns a dictionary iterator object that is able to go through our dataset in real time. So why do we need to do it the complex way? Well, we could load all images into memory and pass them to our neural network for training. But if our dataset is too large, it wouldn't fit into our RAM. When we instead pass our dictionary iterator to the neural network for training, it can just request a bunch of images each training step, and the dictionary iterator will grab it from our dataset folder and pass it to the neural network. This is a really important thing to do when working with datasets containing images or videos. So I hope my explanation was clear enough for you to understand it. In the next step, we create the neural network by using a trained architecture like ResNet 50 and extending it by a few small layers at the end that are trained on our dataset. Don't worry if you don't understand every single line and what it's doing. There's quite some abstraction going on because we used the Keras library to create the neural network. So if you want to know more about dropout or batch normalization, just Google it. It's not hard to understand on a high level once you read a few sentences about it. The last interesting step is the train method. It trains the neural network by calling the Keras fit function, which takes a dataset as the first argument. In our case, it's the dictionary iterator object that can be passed instead of a dataset. That's it. Don't worry if you just understood a few portions, since the code requires quite some knowledge about all kinds of machine learning specifics. If you're still here for the last script, congrats, you have made it through the hardest part. Let's take a look at the predict.py script. We first set a few variables to find the model and the video file that gets analyzed. Then we load the model and the video clip into memory so that we can go through the video frame by frame. Each frame is resized into 224 by 224 pixels, because that's the image size that the networks like ResNet 50 are initially trained on. During our extended training, the dictionary iterator performed the resizing thanks to a parameter called target size. So for each resized frame, the neural network classifies it either as in-game or not in-game. So we save the classification for each frame and average them at the end to get a confidence score that shows how likely the shown video is in-game. Feel free to further go through the code and try to understand as much as possible. If you have any specific question about it, make sure to join the Bot Academy Discord server and ask there. We are over 100 people already. Also, make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks, and I hope to see you in the next video.